So hello friends, today we'll be discussing the most important part of ophthalmology, the image-based questions. So friends, today we'll be discussing 100 image-based questions, which will be very important for all those students who just need a little brush up before their NEET entrance examination. It will be also helpful for those students who have a little ophthalmological knowledge, but they just want to revise whole ophthalmology in a quick span of time. So this session will be discussing 100 image-based questions, and we'll touch the most important high-yield topics in ophthalmology depending upon the images of them. So let's get started. Now, as you can see in this picture, question number one, this picture asks us which anomaly is this. So here, as you can see, there is an iris and there is a defect in the iris. And they are asking you which anomaly is this. So guys, this is a congenital anomaly called as a typical coloboma. Now friends, we know that coloboma means mutilated tissue. So here the iris is malformed. Okay, so this results because of failure of the fetal fissure, the hyoid fissure, to regress within 6th to 7th week of gestation. Normally we have a choroidal fissure, usually in the inferior part, which closes in around 7 to 8 weeks. But when this doesn't closes in time, there will be a defect mostly in the inferior part. So if this coloboma is in inferonasal region, as you can see here, this will be called as a typical coloboma. Now, if you have this defect anywhere else, like here, here, anywhere else except then infranasal region, it would be called as a atypical coloboma. Okay, so this was about the typical or atypical iris coloboma. Now let's read something more about coloboma. So friends, sometimes this defect not only is seen on the iris, but sometimes you see the defect, the coloboma, in every structure of the eyes. So you may have a lens coloboma, you may have a zonular coloboma, you may have a choroidal retinal coloboma or a optic disc coloboma. Okay, so once you see this picture, this suggests that there is a defect in the choroidal and the retinal region. That's why through indirect ophthalmoscopy, you see a white bare area, which is now the sclera. So here the choroid and retina is very thin. That's why you can see the sclera. So this is a picture of choroidal coloboma. Now something like this can also be asked to you. This is a typical disc coloboma. Why a disc coloboma? Because here the disc is enlarged and you see an excavation, you see a defect in the inferior part. So this is a disc coloboma. Now sometimes this disc coloboma can be confused with a very important picture, which is of morning glory syndrome. So what is this morning glory syndrome? Morning glory syndrome is basically a mesodermal defect. Okay, so here there is an absence of lamina cribrosa. Now friends, when you have an absence of lamina cribrosa, you will see there is an excavation, and inside the excavation your disc is present. Now disc definitely becomes enlarged and you actually don't see differentiation of arteries and veins. You see this, just the vessels are radiating parallel to like disc, radiating from the disc, and this resembles a typical morning glory flower, which is in the other picture. So that's why this congenital anomaly, the morning glory syndrome, is named after morning glory flower. So here you have a large disc, your disc is excavated, you have a mesodermal defect, your vessels are radiating from the center of the disc, and you cannot really distinguish between arteries and veins. Okay, so this is your morning glory syndrome. Now let's go back to the question and see what are the other options here. So we have discussed a typical coloboma. This is what we have discussed till now. So what is this ectopic pupil? Guys, sometimes you may have a pupil not in the center, but maybe here, it may be here. So that ectopic pupil is not this picture, but yes, ectopic pupil can be seen very commonly after traumas. Now what else do we have? We have something called as iridodialysis. Now friends, this is an important picture question. This is your iridodialysis. Now I hope you can see very clearly here that there is a problem at the root of the iris. So there is a defect here. Now, this idea to dialysis means a break of the iris from its root. So, this is nothing but a detachment of iris from its root. Okay. So, this commonly occurs after a blunt trauma. Okay. So, there is a defect of the iris from its root. There's a detachment. Now, it leads to a very famous, very common anomaly, which is called as a D-shaped pupil. So, this can be asked to you in a picture question form. D-shaped pupil is seen in, D-shaped pupil is seen in iridodialysis because of blunt trauma. And here is your picture question. Now, the next, the last choice was ICE syndrome. So, let us see what is ICE syndrome. Now, this is again a very famous anomaly where you have problems in the endothelium. Okay. So, this ICE syndrome is nothing but when you have problems at the level of endothelium, the endothelium is faulty here. Okay. So, this ICE syndrome is nothing but you have a iris nevus syndrome. Then you have a Kogan-Reiss syndrome. And the next one is your essential iris atrophy. So, we have discussed this earlier also that ICE syndrome have abnormal endothelium. Now, here you have problems related to the iris. There is a stromal thinning. There is presence of atrophic iris holes. And sometimes you may have a problems in the pupillary size and shape. So, here you have choractopia, you have stromal atrophies, you have iris holes, thin iris, and then you may have problems related to glaucoma. Okay, so this particular picture is showing you ICE syndrome. How can you distinguish it with other things? Because here you see that the iris is very thinned out, there is a stromal atrophy, your pupil is not normal, and you have a thin atrophic iris hole also. Okay, so this have been discussed earlier also in discussion or related to glaucoma. So, this was ICE syndrome.